Good morning, Davao. Good morning, Mindanao. Good morning, North, South, East, and West. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihecatso. For the headlines, weather forecast, easterlies affecting the rest of Mindanao. Local news, Dole to assess effectiveness of child labor aid program. Dabnor acting governor clarifies issue on terminating JO workers. SPMC logs 233 hemophilia patient since 2020. Only 3 of 40 males with testicular cancer seek medical help due to stigma. National news, 66 heat-related illnesses log among students in Central Visayas. Chinese research vessel in East Philippines showing erratic behavior. International news, police name, man whose remains were found in woods. Scarborough women's wants answers after being told she is dead. Entertainment news, part 2 marked the end of an era for true crime. Reigning Miss Universe, Shines Palacios to visit Philippines. And for the sports, CJ Perez is player of the week after pushing Bierman closer to Ilim's swept. United States and Mexico withdraw 2027 Women's World Cup bid. Featured stories, Australia's X-rated underwater show. World record holder for Pope stamps. And side stories. And trivia, do you know that the bustling Bangkirhon Market is a haven for fresh produce and local delicacies? Weather forecast, Davao Region, Sokcharjan, Barm, and Zamboanga Peninsula will have cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm due to intertropical convergence zone. The rest of Mindanao will have a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms due to easterlies, localized thunderstorms, light to moderate winds from east to slight to moderate seas. Local news. The Department of Labor and Employment, DOLE, will review and assess the impact of various interventions that it has provided to the child laborers and their parents. Guesting on the radio program Sayronta Pakigsayod, Serbisyo Alang sa Katawang Pilipino, Child Labor Prevention and Elimination Program Coordinator Dave Andre Villegas of DOLE Davao del Norte Field Office said DOLE is set to stop propelling child laborers in the meantime. Tanawon nato unsa ang impact sa atong different intervention programs nga gipanghatag sa pipila ka mga tuig. We have to see the impact of the different interventions program we have provided over several years, he said. DOLE Davao del Norte started profiling the child laborer in the province in 2018, and Villegas said that the latest report on child profiled child laborers on profiled child labor cases reached 1,037 in 2023. Acting Davao del Norte Governor DiCarlo Oyo Uy explained the issue of allegedly firing job order, JO, worker employed in the Provincial Local Government Unit, PLGU. During a press conference earlier this week, the newly installed acting governor clarified that the employment of JO honorarium and contract of service workers will be concluded after April 24. He said that the removal of JO workers during every change of administrations is a recurring occurrence. In every change of administration, manggawas gyud ning istoryaha nga mananggal na pod ang JO. I will be very clear. 60 days lang ang gihatag nga preventive suspension ni Governor Edwin Ubahib. In the meantime, I am the acting governor. Tanan nga na adiha, ako lang giagi o due process. Same with sa kining mga JO, gibuhat lang pod gyud nako, proseso lang pod, he said. In every change of administration, this issue about removing JO workers always come out. I will be very clear. The preventive suspension of Governor Edwin Ubahib will only last up to 60 days. In the meantime, I am the acting governor and all that included as my job went through due process. Same with the JO. I did it through a process. We also said that the workers are given the opportunity to reapply if they wish to work in provincial offices again. Jaya Apugan, DNSC intern. An official from the Southern Philippines Medical Center, SPMC, said there are around 233 diagnosed patients with hemophilia in Davao region as of 2020. Dr. Jenny B. Ong, chairperson of the Department of Pediatrics at SPMC and project director of Mindanao Hemophilia Center, MHC, who was a guest at Kapihan sa Davao at SM Davao City, said they have 30 to 40 regular pediatric patients in SPMC with hemophilia. She added their youngest patient at SPMC with hemophilia is a one-year-old child, while the oldest patient is 68 years old. A representative from the Southern Philippine Medical Center, SPMC, recorded around 40 patients with testicular cancer from 2017 to 2022, and less than 10% of this number sought medical help. Dr. Jira Dean Travilla, chief president at the Department of Urology of SPMC, said during the Kapihan sa Davao on Monday morning, April 29, 2024, at SM Ecoland, that the number of male diagnosed with testicular cancer, only 6% go to their physicians. Sobrang baba ang pumupunta sa mga doktor nila pag may nakakapa silang bukol sa itlog nila. And so, kapag dumating na sa amin, usually, advanced stage na. The number of male patients who go to their doctors is so low. If they feel some lumps in their testicle, and so if they consulted with us, it is already in the stage or advanced stage, he said. National news. The Department of Health, DOH, urged school to refrain from conducting outdoor activities, noting the 67 heat-related illnesses recorded among students in at least two regions in the country, particular those aged 20 to 21 years old. In a Senate inquiry into the effects of intense heat on classes led by the Committee on Basic Education on Tuesday, April 30, 2024, DOH Epidemiology Bureau head Dr. Vito Roque said that out of the 67 cases recorded from January 1 to April 29, one was in Ilocos region, while the 66 others were in Central Visayas. He said a 14-year-old student from Ilocos experienced difficulty in breathing due to the heat exhaustion, while the students from Central Visayas suffered epigastric pain, hyperventilation, and palpitations. The Chinese research vessel monitored in the eastern portion of the Philippines has shown erratic behavior, an indication that it is conducting studies or maritime research in the seas, Philippine Navy spokesperson Commodore Roy Vincent Trinidad said Tuesday, April 30, 2024. Trinidad said they are continuously monitoring Shen Ku, which reportedly departed Shen port in April 13 and has since been sailing in the Philippine territorial waters, particularly in the vicinity of Batanes and Catanduanes. The Philippine Air Force, on a maritime surveillance flight, was able to get a picture of the ship lowering and unidentified equipment, probably for scientific research or studies, he added. Trinidad said they are currently in the processing of identifying the equipment, which was brought down 100 miles east of Catanduanes. International news. A man whose torso was discovered wrapped in a plastic at a nature reserve has been identified by police. Greater Manchester Police GMP said remains found on wetland at Kersaldale, Salford, on 4 April were believed to be those of 67-year-old Stuart Everett, who live locally. The four said DNA samples, which had seen for urgent analysis, would be able to provide certainty. Two men from Ecos had been charged with murder. A GMP representative said remains found at three others location in Salford will still be tested, but the forces was confident they belong to the same victim. A woman who turned up for a hospital scan only to be told she had already died has demanded an explanation. Bridlington Hospital staff told Susan Johnson, according to their records, she had been dead for 4 months. The Madelmint, the 62-year-old career's allowance for looking after disabled husband Bob, briefly stopped. NHS England said it was aware of an issue involving an incorrect civil death registration, later rectified by our patient's GP. Entertainment news. With a jaw-dropping climax of its first series in 2015, The Jinx kick-started a spate of high-profile true crime shows that including Making a Murderer. Following the backlash against the way those shows glamorize crime and show a lack of respect for victims, could part two mark a turning point for the genre? As TV endings go, they don't come much more jaw-dropping than the finale to the first series of HBO true crime documentary series, The Jinx. After 6 episodes that interrogates U.S. real estate ears, Robert Durst. Connection to the mysterious disappearance of the first wife, along with two brutal murders, the season ended with Durst, not realizing that his mic is still on, heading to the bathroom and uttering to himself the now infamous line, "Kill them all." Of course, seemingly confessing to the murders of the first wife, his best friend, and a former neighbor, you couldn't have scripted it any better. The Nicaraguan beauty queen will arrive in Manila on May 1 and will be staying in the country until May 6. Hello, I'm so excited to share that I will be visiting Manila, Philippines very, very soon. Looking forward to experiencing the rich culture and exploring all that this amazing city has to offer. Palacios said in a video posted on Miss Universe social media pages. Palacios won the Miss Universe crown in El Salvador last year, beating over 80 candidates, including the Philippines' Michelle D, who finished in the top 10. Her predecessor, Filipino-American Arbani Gabriel of the United States, is currently in the Philippines for a series of projects. Gabriel will also be hosting this year Miss Universe Philippines Coronation Night, which will be held on May 22 at the Mall of Asia Arena in Pasay City. For the sports, sweeping the elimination round of the PBA Philippine Cup could arguably be a mere formality for the talent-laden San Miguel Beermen. But CJ Perez, whose consistent performance made him the latest winner of the PBA Press Corps Pilipinas League Player of the Week, cautioned that there's still nothing to be assured for the rampaging Beermen. Kailangan namin masustentuhan yung nilalaro namin at maging consistent sa mga ginagawa namin sa practices at sa games, said Perez, who got the weekly honor for the period of April 24 to 28 after two victories put all Filipino title holders at 9-0. Perez and San Miguel enter the final week of the elimination needed to beat Blackwater and Meralco to achieve the PBA's first perfect elements state since TNT won all 9 games in the 2014 Commissioner's Cup. The U.S. Soccer Federation and Mexican Football Federation have withdrawn their joint bid to host the 2027 FIFA Women's World Cup. The two organizations announced on Monday. The federation said they will instead focus on the bid for the 2031 edition of the tournament, with a call for equal investment as the men's tournament, eliminating investment disparities to fully maximize the commercial potential of the women's tournament. Monday's withdrawal leaves two bids remaining to host the 2027 tournament, one from the Brazilian Football Confederation and a joint bid from the Royal Belgian Football Association, the Royal Netherlands Football Association, and the German Football Association. The announcement of the winning 2027 bid will take place at the 74th FIFA Congress on May. CNN has reached out to FIFA for response to the announcement from the U.S. and Mexico federations. Hosting a World Cup tournament is a huge undertaking, and having additional time to prepare, allows us to maximize its impacts across the globe. U.S. Soccer Federation Cindy Parlukones said in a statement, "I am proud of our commitment to provide equitable experiences for the players, fans, and all our stakeholders. Shifting our bids will enable us to host a record-breaking Women's World Cup in 2031 that will help to grow and raise the level of the women's game both here at homes as well as across the globe. There will still be a congested calendar for the international soccer competition in the United States over the next several years." Featured stories. Each year, the small South Australian town of Whyalla becomes home to one of the most spectacular underwater events, the spawning of the giant Australian cuttlefish. First time you go and put your hands under the water and see hundreds of cuttlefish in this one little area. It just looked like a chaotic kaleidoscope. "What the hell is going on here?" said Tony Bramley. As owner of Yala Diving Services and a decades-long advocate for a giant Australian cuttlefish, Bramley has observed the frenzied and colorful cuttlefish mating that occurs in South Australia's Upper Spencer Marine Golf Park for years. Once only of interest to fishermen and local scuba divers, who would spread the word to one another that the cuttlefish are in. This marine phenomenon now attracts tourists and researchers from across the world. It's a welcome boast to the small steelworks town of Whyalla on South Australia's Eyre Peninsula. Stamp collector and Boy Scout of the Philippine Secretary General Kim Robert De Leon shows his collection during the exhibit of the Philippine Post Office held on the Robinson's Mall in Manila on Monday. De Leon is the holder of the Guinness World Record of the largest stamp collections of stamps featuring the Pope by a Filipino. His collection of 2,398 stamps were achieved the De Leon of February 2022. And for the side story, let's watch this. for the trivia, do you know that the bustling Bangkiruhan market is haven for fresh produce and local delicacies? Visitors can immerse themselves in the vibrant sight and sounds of a traditional Filipino market. That's all our news for today. Please like, share, subscribe, and click the bell button for you to be updated on the Pinoy Rub News Channel. This is Gilbert Lopez Martihecatso. Good morning.